Space, the final frontier. With private companies like SpaceX and Blue Origin putting space exploration on their shoulders, humans are going to be spending a lot more time away from Earth. But our bodies were specifically made for Earth. Here are the weirdest things that happen to the human body in space. Number 10. You can take as much calcium supplements and drink as much milk as you want. But if you're spending time in space, you're going to lose bone. Bones are super important for our bodies. They provide structure that allows us to move. Unfortunately, they're not built for space. Bones are able to stay strong here on Earth because of the constant resistance they receive from the planet's gravitational pull. This ongoing pressure allows our bones to continually remodel. During spaceflight, however, there is no gravity. When you're floating around out there in the great beyond, your bones begin to weaken. A reduction of bone mineral density sets in, and research has shown that there is a 3.5% loss of bone after just 16 to 18 weeks of spaceflight. Most of that occurs in weight-bearing bones, like the pelvis and the legs. Pop quiz, hotshot! Mankind has been sending people up into space for decades. We've been getting better and better at keeping our men and women off the planet. What do you think is the longest that a human has ever spent in space? See if you can guess the correct answer in the comments below, and I'll let you know later on in the video if you're right. Number 9. In space, your body is absolutely bombarded with cosmic radiation, which is nowhere near as cool as it sounds. It's real bad for you, and so far, there are no cases of it giving astronauts superpowers. So, all around, a bad thing to inflict on your body. On the International Space Station, people are exposed to 9 times more radiation than we get here on Earth. As it happens, Earth's atmosphere, the one that we've been playing fast and loose with for decades, is actually protecting us from most of this space radiation. The more radiation you're exposed to, the more you run the risk of damaging your nervous system, which typically results in reduced motor function, altered cognitive function, and weirdest of all, behavioral changes. And that's not even mentioning the radiation sickness, with symptoms of nausea, vomiting, and fatigue, very similar to how you feel after wolfing down a Whopper from Burger King. Number 8. Perhaps one of the best things about living in space is that you don't need to spend any money on manicures. Why is that? Well, because in space, your fingernails fall out. This phenomenon is known as fingernail delamination, and in a recent study, 22 astronauts reported losing their fingernails while in space. Turns out that fingernail trauma is among spacewalkers' biggest complaints. Astronaut gloves are built to simulate the pressure here on Earth. In order to do that, they're made with a thick rubber inside of a space-proof shell. While working, the spacewalkers are constantly fighting against these bulky gloves. The constant chafing causes blisters, and eventually, your fingernails just pop off. Some astronauts have gone as far as ripping out their fingernails before spacewalks, just to get it over with. Number 7. They say that space travel isn't for the faint of heart, but it turns out that just traveling in space will make your heart faint. Many parts of the human body's cardiovascular system are influenced by Earth's gravity. Our veins, for example, work by pushing against gravity to get blood back to the heart. In the absence of a gravitational pull, your heart can actually change. And the longer you stay up there, the more extreme the changes get. The size and the shape of the heart are affected, including a decrease in the size of the right and the left ventricles. Fun fact, your heart rate is actually slower in space. They've done research on the hearts of astronauts in space and have found that the heart rate of someone standing in the International Space Station is actually the same as someone who is laying down on Earth. The muscles in the heart begin to weaken as well, and they end up pumping less blood with each beat. This is not very good because the heart is real crucial for your health. Number 6. Being in space can mess with your vision. About 80% of astronauts report vision problems when they come back to Earth. It's known as visual impairment intracranial pressure syndrome, or VIIP for short. What's happening is that while in space, your eyes actually flatten and your retinas are pushed forward. Also, your brain floats upwards and it actually starts to crush your optic nerves. Number 5. When you're in space, you stop snoring. That sounds like heaven off Earth. When you're traveling around the cosmos, you never have to worry about cramming earplugs into your head because your sleep partner's snores sound like they're trying to start a lawnmower. Because of the absence of gravity on your respiratory system, there's a considerable reduction in sleep-related breathing problems in space. Also, without that pesky gravity to affect your tongue, you won't have any of the normal blockages that typically lead to snoring here on Earth. Before we move on, be sure to subscribe, hit the bell button to get notified of new videos, and we always appreciate a big thumbs up. Number 4. Ever since humans became capable of space travel, astronauts have reported life-changing experiences while in orbit. American astronaut Charlie Duke, who flew in Apollo 16, said about his time in space, quote, "I was overwhelmed by the certainty that what I was witnessing was part of the universality of God. I just choked up. Tears came. It was the most deeply moving experience of my life." End quote. The phenomenon is known as space euphoria. Astronaut Rusty Squeakart recounts the thoughts in his head about looking back at Earth from space. Quote, "This tiny, beautiful Earth, the planet that keeps us alive, which gives us everything we have, the food we eat, the water that we drink, the air that we breathe, the beauty of nature, and everything is so perfectly balanced and organized so that we can live. This tiny, beautiful planet spinning through space." End quote. Astronauts are hit with such intense serenity and awe that their perceptions about life are changed forever. Number 3. In space, everyone is taller. While in zero gravity, your vertebrae begin to spread apart and this causes your spine to lengthen. When they're not affected by gravity, people grow by 3% of their body length. If you become an astronaut and spend a few months in space, you'll finally be able to try out for the beach volleyball league that you've been dying to join. You'll be able to reach the soup can on top of the shelf, and you'll be able to go on every ride at Disneyland. I'm only kidding. After a few months back on Earth, your spine contracts back to its normal length. Number 2. If you're unlucky enough to have a suit malfunction while floating around in the vacuum of space, you have about 15 seconds before all of the oxygen in your body is gone. The air that you have in your respiratory system will begin to aggressively expand until your lungs erupt like a birthday balloon. So if you want to buy yourself an extra 6 seconds, then exhale all the air from your body that you can. Next up, the saliva on your tongue will start to boil somehow, and if any of your skin is exposed to the sun, you'll get the worst sunburn of your soon-to-be-over life. Depending on how close you are to a star, your body will either become a mummy or an icicle. Both are bad options. And then you just sort of float around forever. It's not a pleasant way to go. It's answer time. The person who spent the most time up in space is a Russian gentleman by the name of Valery Polyakov. Valery was born in 1942 in the Soviet Union, and he was a doctor before he became a Russian cosmonaut. In 1944, the Russians sent him up into space for 437 consecutive days. During that time, he conducted a ton of scientific research and experiments. He was given the award of Hero from the Russian Federation and got 2 extra rations of pork. Number 1. When you're in space, your brain starts to float. You become a real space cadet. It follows that without gravity, things in your body can shift around, and researchers have found that the brain is one of those things. The brain actually shifts upward when you're in space, which is less than ideal. On Earth, the protective fluid that surrounds the brain is typically equal on all sides. But in space, the fluid that is between the brain and the top of the head is dispersed in half. brains are crazy sensitive. Ask any football player. And they've conducted studies that have shown that this compression of the brain can redound to some pretty rough symptoms, including really weird headaches and nausea.